The hot scoring teenagers team from Pittsburgh, the Penguins. The scoring leaders team from New York, the Rangers. Two rivals, Jaromir Jagr's former team and his present one. It used to be a team with big names and little success, but these Rangers had a different plan. Led by Jaromir Jagr and rookie goalie Henrik Lundqvist, the Blue Shirts are shocking skeptics and leaving the league wondering how good they can be. In Pittsburgh, a gifted 18-year-old has been dubbed the league's next great star. But the Penguins can't afford to wait. Sidney Crosby needs to carry his team today. Is he ready?
Come on, boys, let's have some energy here.
Answers ahead. It's the NHL on NBC. From Madison Square Garden in New York, NBC is proud to present the Pittsburgh Penguins and the New York Rangers. Good afternoon, everyone. Along with John Davidson, I'm Mike Emrick. Since last weekend, Mario Lemieux has retired. What's the effect on Sidney?
Well, Sidney's now...
Obvious mathematics, it's a best 4 out of 7, not 3. So there's still hope here outside Madison Square Garden in New York. Versus tincture to Game 4, Eastern Conference semifinal. Those New York Rangers against the team that has won the first 3, the Pittsburgh Penguins. Good evening, everyone, along with Eddie Olchek, Christine Simpson in a moment. I'm Mike Emrick. Since we last left you, Sean Avery out for the rest of the playoffs. He is not able to play for the New York Rangers. An offensive threat.
What a goal! It's by one score!
Welcome to Washington, D.C. Welcome to the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico. Just 11 blocks from the White House is Verizon Center, home to the Capitals and where the fans come already wearing red and hoping to be inspired to make a lot of noise for their team. The NBC Sports Network is proud to bring you Eastern Conference Semifinal Game 3. Capitals and Rangers are tied. Good evening, everyone. Along with Eddie Olchek, Pierre McGuire in just a moment, I'm Mike Emrick. The number of minutes that a star defenseman plays in the course of a game, 26-plus. A star forward, 21-plus. The horn sounds, and the Lightning have won it. After they regained home ice advantage, Tampa Bay would have a new face in net, while Chicago looked to their stars to produce a much-needed win.
Here we go, boys. Here we go, right?
Olsen with a shot. Their captain was the first to deliver. It's tame. Tampa Bay would respond as they've done throughout this entire Stanley Cup run and let everyone know they would not go quietly. But frustration would soon turn to elation for the battle-tested Blackhawks. The battle on for it, and it's Saad driving around in front. The third period goal was prelude to a frantic finish. Fires! Save! Rebound! Scramble in front! Another shot! It wouldn't go! In what felt like an eternity, the Lightning fired everything they had at Chicago in the closing minutes. But the two-time champs held on. And now it's anyone's series, all tied up at 2. Game 5 next.
Well, who steps up, Doc, as a goaltender?
Edmonton, Rogers Place, 4 years old. Inside the Stanley Cup, 127 years old. Tampa Bay's Nikita Kucherov leads the playoffs in points. Could have the Stanley Cup tonight. American-born Joe Pavelski of Dallas, no one with more playoff goals, and could force a Game 7 Wednesday. The wonderful battle resumes. Game 6, next.
Well, you don't see this very often. Back-to-back games in a Stanley Cup final.
If Game 4 left you wanting more...
Near side shot, Kirby shoots, he scores! The Tampa Bay Lightning win Game 4 in overtime!
Less than 24 hours later, the Game 5 sequel delivered. More action, and a shot score! Corey Perry! The veteran stashed it, and it's 1-0 with higher stakes.
Shoot! Score!
And it's 2-1. One team on the verge of a championship, the other fighting for survival. An American star kept their cup hopes alive.
He must score! Pavelski has tied the game!
Extending the run time again.
It's going to take overtime.
With some scenes too hard to watch.
Here's Johnson and Sean! And that one wouldn't go. My goodness!
And as the drama heightened,
we're going to hit double overtime in game 5.
A star veteran, not ready to go home, broke through again. Chance to lift the cup, another chance to fight on. It's game 6 next.
It's the Stanley Cup final presented by Geico. The best of 7 is now at game 6. The Tampa Bay Lightning and the Dallas Stars. And good evening, everyone. I'm Mike Emrick. The last two games were filled with great theater, lead changes, heavy hits, hard driving, scoring plays, overtimes, and both teams won a game. It was a joy to watch, unless you were a fan of one of the two teams, and then you were absolutely wrung out. But we're back here tonight. All of you are too. Thrilled to be able to watch all of this again.
It is glorious, magnificent. The words don't really describe it, especially when you get to hold it. Weighs about 35 pounds. Guys with hernias have gone out onto the ice after they couldn't play anymore, and they were surgically repaired, not able to play to finish. But they were sure able to pick it up and hold it up high, risking torn stitches. The sacrifices that you make to somehow or other try to get that cup in your hands and eventually get your name on it, letter by letter. Puck comes back to the point. Led on across for a shot, and that one deflected away. Diving play is made back out and kicked back along, and still they scrap for possession. Right around in front. Oh, and another shot that went wide to the last 22. Back to the point again. Klingberg got it on across. Held there. Another shot. Scrap for possession. Scramble in front. Around behind now. Taken along by Radulov. Got it on back to the point, and another shot is blocked back down. They hustle back for it, and trying to get there, and they get a trigger pull of a shot that went wide that time. Was Goodrow, and the Tampa Bay Lightning have won the Stanley Cup. Unity among all the players, both on and away from the bubble rinks. Game 130, day 59. One team will get their names on the trophy, the other disappointed. But deep in the heart of Texas, what a gallant performance by the team in green. And John Cooper has now won at every level that he has coached. Absolutely magnificently done. He only played part of one period, dating back to February. But there is no one who denies how important he was. Victor Hedman raises the cup next.
Only two defensemen in NHL history scoring more goals in a playoff run. Brian Leetch, Paul Coffey, and he hands it off to Braden Coburn, who did a wonderful job back in the other half of the bubble, Doc, in Toronto, coming in when they had some injuries. Ryan McDonough, second trip to the Stanley Cup Final. This one, he's on the winning end. Passes off to Alex Killorn. Some huge goals, some huge penalty kills, some hard minutes. How about Luke Shen? Another guy added in, sitting there for weeks at a time, not playing, and getting the tap on the shoulder from John Cooper, playing seven defensemen at times. Some incredible opportunity, and Zach Bogosian brought in by general manager Julien Brisebois. And the change in dynamic from this team from last, and Pat Maroon, Doc, back-to-back Stanley Cup championships last year in St. Louis and this year in Tampa.
Doesn't seem like it's old stuff to him, does it? Thanks for watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico. For most post-game coverage, including celebrations, interviews, and the T-Mobile three stars of the game, tune in to NHL Overtime, which begins now on NBCSN. We hope you've enjoyed the coverage on NBC, but continue on with NBCSN. For Eddie Olczyk, Brian Boucher, and our entire crew, Mike Emrick saying so long.
NBC Sports thanks you for watching this presentation of the National Hockey League.